You may remember last week there was a bit of an uproar on social media when a lot of blue check marks came out and said, what is the president talking about? Coyotes bringing children across the border? He must be crazy. But a lot of people who are familiar with the situation said, wow, this is very eye-opening, because now we're understanding these people that are pushing for an open border right now don't understand the dangers to these children, what's actually happening, because they don't understand even the words that are being used to describe what's going on. Well, one woman who understands very well is Namrata Singh Gujral. I want to bring her in right now. She is the director of America's Forgotten. Welcome to the program. We want to hear all about how you understand the story, because you're a filmmaker and you're actually bringing this story to life in a way that a lot of Americans would see it differently than they do. So tell us your story about behind America's Forgotten.
Tudor, first of all, thank you so much for having me. I'm very happy to be here. I just released a picture called America's Forgotten. It's a documentary that was shot around the world in many different countries. It actually started as a very pro-caravan, pro-illegal immigration documentary. In full disclosure, I'm a registered Democrat, and I just want to put that out there. But I think it's important to say that, because as I navigated the world and I made this film, I realized the downfall, not even just downfall, just the grave dangers of illegal immigration. I actually did an about pivot in the picture and changed my stance on illegal immigration. And at this point, I just really think illegal immigration is a bad idea. Coyotes is a real term. No, it's not just the animals. Coyotes is a term that's used for smugglers and agents and sub-agents around the world. There's an entire chain that we talk about in the film with some very well-known journalists from overseas that are in the movie. And what President Trump said in the past, the last debate with coyotes and social media went on fire. Coyotes is a real term, and illegal immigration is a grave danger to America and the world.
So you say you changed your opinion, and I want to reiterate, you are a registered Democrat, but in your journey, you changed your opinion because you realized the danger. Do you have any examples of what really changed your mind?
Yes, absolutely. So we follow four stories in the film, and two of them, and I wanted to be very fair, and I wanted to be very unbiased. So two of the stories are Americans that might have been hurt by illegal immigration, and two stories are actually stories of migrants. One of them is a woman who's lived here from Central America for a long time, and we talk about her story in the film, and it's very sad. There's a line that she says in the film where she says, I came to America, all I wanted was a lot of food, a lot of clothes, and I want to go to Disneyland. And then this is heartbreaking, she says, I've never been to Disneyland, and she's been here for many years. But truly, I think the pivotal moment for me, Tudor, was I follow the story of a young six-year-old in the film who was brought to the Mexican border by her parents, and they claimed asylum. And that's the story that I was following. And when I went to their hometown in India, which is something that was set up by the Indian Express journalist, it's a very big newspaper in India, we actually drove past that house about five or six times because we kept looking for like a more impoverished area or somewhere where there would be like a violence-stricken area, or perhaps there would be some kind of, you know, maybe a persecution type situation. And this looked like for India, a pretty decent area. I mean, it was, I would say perhaps not, you know, not even lower middle class, perhaps even a step up from there. And I think that was the pivotal moment for me because CNN had done coverage on with the same family members in that same house 2 days around my interview, and CNN just put out coverage that said they're declaring asylum, these poor people. And when I went there and I said to the grandfather, I said, I don't see poverty, I don't see persecution, I don't see violence. Are you able to tell me why this child, so this little child actually died on the border, she died of dehydration. And I said, are you able to tell me why your family decided to make that trek and now your granddaughter is gone? And it'll shock you, his response in the film. And I think that was the pivotal moment for me. I walked out of there and I just thought, this story needs to be told. I came back, I talked to my friends in Hollywood, pretty much everyone said to me, no, 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 just don't even put it out. You know, that's not the story. I mean, that's not what we're looking to do. And I said, but at what point do you not tell the story that you're seeing through your lens versus the story that you have in your head with preconceived notions? And I didn't make any friends. I lost a lot of friends, but I think the film is an eye-opener.
Absolutely. You're talking about a migrant. Most people are thinking that's Central America, but you're talking about someone coming here from India thinking that they could get just a little bit of a better life, and ultimately their six-year-old died. That is a terrible story. We have about a minute left. I want you to tell our audience where they can find your film, because you have had trouble getting it out there.
Yes. Amazon, if you're listening, please release my film. In the meantime, guys, please support the picture, americasforgottenmovie.com. We have it on Salem, we have it on Vimeo, and we have it on a couple of other platforms. But if you just Google or go to americasforgottenmovie.com, I would love your support.
Thank you so much. And you really believe that if people go in and watch this movie, there's a chance that they will understand why there are folks, including Border Patrol, who are saying the border needs to be protected for the migrants, not necessarily for the U.S. Is that right?
That is right, to the point that because of this film, I've decided not to vote for Joe Biden this year and the Democrats' terrible policies on illegal immigration. I'm going to vote for President Trump.
Wow. Thank you so much, Namrata Gujral. Thank you so much. She is the director of America's Forgotten. Big announcement here today on America's Voice Live. Stay tuned. We'll be right back after this break.